Have you been in the middle of generating beautiful AI images in Midjourney when you realize the image is just 90% of the way there? And no matter how hard you try, you just can't get that extra 10% out of Midjourney. You can try upscaling, reprompting it, just variations of it, but it's just not getting there. Well, I think I found our solution. There I was, going about my day creating an AI-generated short story. I wanted to zoom in on one of my images for the story, but realized the quality faded quickly. I tried using the upscale features in Midjourney, but alas, nothing was working. I needed a new solution, so I did what any person in my situation would do, turn to Twitter or X, whatever. I read a bunch of posts around this new Krea AI and decided to give it a shot. But I wasn't ready for what was to come. It turned my blotchy, pixelated king into the dashing sovereign he was always meant to be. Okay, story time over. So what is this magic software and what exactly does it do? Krea AI is a platform that allows you to generate images in real time as well as upscale and enhance them. Let's check out the real-time generation in action. So as you can see here, I have a random image generated, a vast terracotta badlands sculpted by wind and water over millennia. Hopefully I said that right. You'll notice that the platform seems relatively simple compared to some of the other ones, which is nice. But one of the things that should seem familiar is the text prompt at the bottom. This is where we can use text to generate images. So for example, let's say an Amazon rainforest with a jaguar in the bush. Now, as you can see, this is a work in progress. It's still kind of learning. I would say Midjourney in regard to image generation is probably much better. However, in order to fix this, we can use this little button on the left, which is variation. So let's go ahead and click that. There we go. So that's more of what we were looking for. And you can hit the variation as many times as you want. You can also just click on random prompt if you need some inspiration or ideas. So let's say this is the image that we want to generate. The next step would be to click enhance here at the top, but before we do that, let's check out some of the other features. So on the right-hand side, we have a few ways that you can alter your image. The first is default, or the way that we're currently viewing it, right? When I click on it, nothing happens. The second is portrait, and this will try to add a little bit more of a portrait look to the image. I think ours was already sort of a portrait style, so it didn't change it too much, but maybe you like this one better. You can also play with concept, CGI, or cartoon. As I said before, this is a little bit of a work in progress, so a lot of times I prefer to generate my images in Midjourney and then move them over to Krea to enhance and upscale them. However, I just wanted to show you that Krea does allow you to generate images itself. Now, before we move on to enhance, let's just check on the left side real quick. I'm not gonna get too deep into these. If you're interested, I recommend you play with them more. However, we do have an image to image. And what this image to image does is it allows you to add in photos, add in shapes. The odd part though is that when you add in these extra images and shapes, it doesn't seem to have a one-to-one effect from the image to the left to the right. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. When I move this circle around in another space, it changes the image. However, I'm not really sure how to predict if I move it up what that's supposed to do, or if I move it down. I guess it gives you more ways to generate images, which is cool. And as I said, you play around with this. You can add more shapes, you can generate an image, you can upload an image, and just see how it changes your image on the right. However, the right will always stay true to your text prompt at the bottom here. Some other ways that you can alter your image are actually using your screen to image. This one's really interesting. So you're just gonna share your screen and that's going to alter the image. And then the last one is camera, which I'll turn on briefly here. And as you can see, I'm using myself to alter the image, albeit very slightly, but another way that you can kind of play with the software here. So let's go back to our text to image. So let's say this is the image that we want to choose. It's a cool looking image, and the next step would be to click on send to enhance and upscale. Okay, so now we've made it to the enhance section. And again, it's a pretty simple interface here, right? We have our image, we have our prompt, we have our upscaling factor. So once you pay for the platform, you're able to upscale it to a much higher resolution. Right now I have the pro plan, I believe, and I'm able to upscale to 4K or 4X. For style, you can choose any one of these options, similar to what we were looking at in the generation. It's kind of a preset styles. There's not a ton of them, but they can add different styles to your photo. So it's interesting to check these out. And then here's where the bread and butter is AI strength and resemblance strength. So let's generate a few examples here to see what this does to our image and what it makes it look like. First, I'm gonna set the AI strength a little bit higher. So we're gonna start this at 75. And AI strength adds more, looks like I can't get 75, so we'll do 76. AI strength adds more detail to the image, but you need to be careful because sometimes it can add extra artifacts to it that just make it look a little bit overpixelated. So for the first example, I'm gonna keep resemblance strength at 70. Resemblance strength is exactly what it says it is. It's how much you wanna continue to resemble the image. So if it's like a big city skyscraper scene, you can set the resemblance lower and let it do a little bit more with some of the creativity it has. However, if you're looking at a person or a subject like we are, I would set the resemblance strength a bit higher. I think 70 is fine right now. So let's give 0.76 AI strength a test. While the images are processing, I got my first one back. And one of the coolest things it does is it gives this slider that allows you to see the before and after. So let's put it all the way to the right. I love doing this. And just slide it across and see, it's incredible how much detail it adds to these images. And this is why I say this is the bread and butter. Think about the image generation itself. It's okay, you could see some kind of odd, you saw some odd images being created with the prompt. So this is why I like to use Midjourney for the images. Put them in here where you just click on this image, upload your own, and then upscale it because it is magnificent. Okay, so let's see all three of them side by side now. You'll notice that 0.75 AI strength creates a very, very detailed image. The 0.5 looks really, really good as well. I would say it's a little less sharp than the 0.75, but I'm more than happy with that. And then the 0.25 obviously didn't do a whole lot. The strength is relatively low. So although it is more detailed than the base image, it's more of a lighter upscale, I guess I would say. Now, before we get out of here today, I want to show you some of the before and afters using Krea AI. Thank you all so much for checking out today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you want to see next, and I will see you all soon.